The NumPy Append function allows us to add new values to the end of an existing NumPy array. This function returns a copy of the existing array with the values appended to the specified axis. We will start by creating a new script with the NumPy library imported as np. Next, we will create a new array called numbers by calling np.arrange and passing in the integer 9. This function will create a NumPy array with integers ranging from 0 up to, but not including 9, with a step size of 1 in between each element. Check out our video on the NumPy arrange function for more information. Now we will use the append function by calling np.append. Within this function, the first argument we will pass in is our existing NumPy array numbers. The second argument we will pass in is the new values that we want to add to the numbers array. We are able to pass a single value, such as the integer 9, and when the result is printed to the console, we can see the new value is added to the numbers array. It is important to note that the append function returns a new copy of the numbers array and does not modify the original array. If we print the numbers array after the append function is called, we can see it is unchanged. If we add a value other than an integer to the numbers array, such as the float 9.1, all values in the resulting array will be converted to floats. To add more than one value to the numbers array, we have a few options. We can pass a tuple with the values of 9 and 10 separated by a comma to the second argument of the append function. The resulting array now contains our new values. The second option is to pass the same values within a list, and when the result is printed to the console, we can see the values have been appended to the array. To work with the last argument in the append function, the axis keyword, we will need a multidimensional array. We will define a new variable, numbers2d, and set this equal to numbers.reshape. This function will change the shape of the numbers array into the specified number of rows and columns if possible. We will add the 3 to specify the number of rows, followed by a comma with the value of 3 for the number of columns. When we print the numbers2d array to the console, the resulting array has the same values as the numbers array, but the shape now has 3 rows and 3 columns. Now that we have a 2d array, let's call np.append. We will add the numbers2d array as the first argument and then specify a list with the values of 9, 10, and 11 within square brackets as the second argument. The last argument we will add contains the axis keyword. This specifies how the new values will be added to the existing numbers2d array. A value of 0 for the axis keyword means the new values will be appended as a row, and a value of 1 means the new values will be appended as a column. We will pass in the value of 0 for the axis keyword to append the new values as a row, and then print the result to the console. However, when the append function is called, we get an error because the new values we are appending are in the form of a single dimension array, whereas the numbers2d array is two-dimensional. To solve this error, we must add another set of square brackets around the new values we want to append to create a 2d array. Now when the result is printed to the console, we can see our new values 9, 10, and 11 have been added as a fourth row to the numbers2d array. For more Python tutorials, like, share, and subscribe to the PyPros channel.